Hi, I'm Angie, and today I wanted to show you the stitch Bible that I made. This is just a little reference tool for me to have beside my Horizon 7700. It shows me all the stitches that are available on my machine and what they look like when they're stitched out, because they can be quite different when they're actually stitched compared to the little picture that's on the sewing machine. The way I created the stitch Bible is to take some pieces of muslin and adhere some heavyweight interfacing onto the back so that it's a little bit stiffer than just a single piece of fabric, and that way you don't get too much puckering. And I went through the machine in numerical order and stitched each stitch and started with the default settings that are set on the machine and stitched about an inch or two of that, and then I lengthened the stitch width and then I lengthened the stitch length. So I didn't do that for every single stitch, because once I got back into the decorative stitches, I probably wouldn't change those settings because it would distort the little pictures too much. And then using a Sharpie, I would just write down the number of the stitch that I had just stitched out. And a nice feature on the Janome Horizon is that you can take off the foot pedal and just use the start-stop button, so that makes it really easy to just stitch a little bit of each one. The reason I use long, narrow pages like this is because I didn't want to stitch forever, and it's kind of boring to stitch out all the stitches. With the Horizon, there are over 250 stitches, so it kind of was a work in progress and took a little bit of time to do all the stitches. Once I had my pages of stitches, then I put them back to back, and I fused them with Wonder Under in between, and then I used rat tail binding and zigzagged it around the border of each page so that it was a little bit firmer and stood up nicely and has a nice finish. Once that was all done, I used my crocodile to punch holes in the side, and I put grommets. I didn't have enough for every single page, but on the front and back I used these eyelets, and then in the middle pages I put one in the top and the bottom. And then I used my cinch to add the wire binding to it and just added some fibers for decoration. As you can see, for my cover, I used my machine to stitch out Stitch Bible, and then I actually did some Stupendous Stitching. This is where I actually learned how to do the Stitch Bible from the Stupendous Stitching course on Craftsy, and I highly recommend it. It was a great course. And this is what the Stupendous Stitching looks like. So you start with couching some material onto your fabric, and then you add some decorative machine stitching, and then you do a little bit of hand embroidery. So I just did a little sort of sampling of each one. I really like the way it turned out. So as you can see, it's a great reference for when I'm ready to do some work and I need to know what kind of stitch I would like to select. I can see exactly what they look like, what will happen to them if I change the default settings. And in the process, I've learned everything that my machine is capable of doing, and also verifying that it actually will stitch out everything perfectly, and it does, no problems. So it took me a couple weeks of a little bit of sewing each night to get all the pages done, and then putting it together was really fun. Here's all the letters that are available. So there's three sets of alphabets with uppercase and lowercase, and numbers, of course. And then these are the utility stitches and how they look too. So thanks for watching. I just wanted to share my Stitch Bible with you, and I really recommend you go check out the Stupendous Stitching course on Craftsy with Caroline Walsh. She's a great teacher, and it's a lot of fun.